you know, Freddie is probably a classic boogeyman. I mean, you know, the Brothers Grimm have been watered down for a century by Disney, but the original Hansel and Gretel is a very dark tale. It's a German famine. If you don't behave, we will send you out into the woods without any food. Yeah. And what happens when you're starving? You hallucinate. And what would you hallucinate? A house made of food and candy and cake and a witch, perhaps, that you've been warned about. And the Nightmare on Elm Street films also kind of serve as a cautionary tale, a kind of dark fairy tale to an adolescent generation that there is evil out there, that that's a class you don't get to take in middle school or high school. You know, it's like there's never a class in Life is Not Fair, and there's never this class called Life is Too Short, and there's never a class called There's Some Really Nasty Stuff Out There. You don't take those classes in school. And yet, that's the lesson, I think, of Freddie, on that cusp of maturity, of puberty into adulthood, that I think, especially with the young woman, the woman warrior, that is in every one of the Nightmare on Elm Street films, and usually vanquishes Freddy. But that's sort of the theme, you know, that's the theme of those films, that you have to confront this sooner or later in your life, and it makes you stronger. And so I always look at them as a kind of fairy tale, kind of mid-80s to mid-90s fairy tale that was told and kind of has some legs now because it was a sort of suburban moment of time. We were a little bit ahead of the curve, and now, in fact, it's what's happening all over the world.